So here's the story. I accidentally assigned this question to my Calculus 1 students for homework. And I don't think this question is fair at all. Because first, keep in mind that we are in the product rule and also the quotient rule section, and the question is asking us to find the first and also the second derivative of this function. And of course, we can just use the quotient rule to get the first derivative, no big deal. Okay, now we are going to work out the second... How the f*** do you do second derivative? But how are we going to differentiate this again? Not only it's long, but also we do not have the chain rule yet. Seriously? Well, I checked the answer in the back of the book. They did provide an answer. I don't know. And because I assigned it, so I feel like I should do it, even though I told my students that they don't have to do it. But let's just see how we can possibly do this, and we are not going to be using the chain rule. So here we go. Of course, I have the first derivative right here already. So let's go ahead and just put on f double prime. And let's put on a big fraction bar. I think that should be enough. Let's do the easy part first. Square the bottom. So we have 1 plus e to the x square. And we have to square this thanks to the quotient rule. Now, put on the bottom function on the top, right? I'm going to write it down right here. You guys will see why. 1 plus e to the x square. And then we are going to multiply by the derivative of the top. All right, derivative of 2x is just a 2, no big deal. And the derivative of 2x times e to the x, we will have to use the product rule. Here we go. We add the first function, and we multiply by the derivative of the second, which is just e to the x. And then we add the second function, which is e to the x, times the derivative of the first, which is a 2. Okay? And now we have to differentiate this again by using the product rule. Yeah, let me keep this as the first function, so we will have minus x squared times the derivative we have, which is e to the x, and then we add the second function times the derivative of the first, which is negative 2x, all right? And that's pretty good. So that's just the first part of the top of the quotient rule. Now, we are going to minus the top function, so let's just go and write that down. So it's 2x plus 2x e to the x minus x squared e to the x. And then we multiply by the derivative of the bottom. We do not have the quotient rule, so this is what we will have to do. So have a look right here. I am going to write this down twice. So we are going to be differentiating 1 plus e to the x times 1 plus e to the x. So this is how you can get around from not using the chain rule. Okay, product rule in action. All right, keep the first function, which is going to be 1 plus e to the x, and we multiply by the derivative of the second, which is e to the x. All right, and then we add a second function, which is this, which is 1 plus e to the x, and we multiply by the derivative of the first, which is just e to the x. So in fact, they are the same thing, yeah. And then we will just get 2 of this, so 2 e to the x times 1 plus e to the x, yeah. It looks like we should distribute it inside, right? But no, because if we put this down right here, we are going to factor out the 1 plus e to the x to the first power. That's, I'm not going to say cool, because I don't really think so. Anyway, I'm going to factor out 1 plus e to the x to the first power, and not see what we have left, yeah? Right here, we will just have 1 plus e to the x. And keep in mind, we will still have to distribute. So let me just put that down. And then for this part, have a look. This is 2x times e to the x. And this is negative 2x times e to the x. So in fact, this and that cancel each other out. I'm not even going to say pretty nicely. All right. So let me just write down the rest, which is 2 right here. And then plus 2 e to the x. And then minus x squared e to the x. So hopefully, so far, so good. Okay, Now, I'm going to multiply this out, and then we'll put down the result in a parenthesis here. So 1 times all that, which is just all that, and that's 2 plus 2 e to the x minus x squared e to the x. And then we do e to the x times all that, so it's plus 2 e to the x, and then plus. Okay, e to the x times e to the x is e to the 2x, right? So we have 2 e to the 2x, and then this times that, so again, we will just have minus x squared e to the 2x. Okay, and then for the second part here, we will take this, multiply with all that, and keep in mind, we will also have to distribute. So we will have minus first, and then this times that is 4 x e to the x, and then minus, and then we have 4 again, x e to the 2x, because we have 2 e to the x, so e to the 2x. And lastly, this is going to be a plus 2 x squared e to the x squared. So e to the 2x, like that. On the bottom, yeah, fourth power, so that's pretty good. 1 plus e to the x to the fourth power, aha! This and that can cancel, we get the third power. All right, and we'll just compile like terms on the top, and then I will have to check the answer because I don't have the answer remembered yet, even though I tried to work that out earlier. Right. So let's see. On the top, this is just an only number, right? So I'm going to write down a 2 right here. And we see that this is 2e to the x and then e to the x. And is there anything else that has just e to the x? No. So we just have plus 4e to the x. Do we have any x e to the x? Just this, right? But this is not the same as that. So the next thing that we do will be this. So I will just say minus 4x e to the x. So far so good, huh? And then next, x squared and e to the x, right? This is not that because this is e to the 2x. And this right here is, which is what we want, minus x squared e to the x. So this is also done. Okay, let's look for e to the 2x. This is the only one that has e to the 2x, so we will just write down plus 2 e to the 2x. So this is done. And then x e to the 2x, which is this, zigzag for this, we have minus 4x e to the 2x. And lastly, oh wow, look at that. This is like a small bonus. What do I do with this? Let's put on blue right here. So this part and that part can be combined. Wow, negative x squared e to the 2x and 2 of them, right? So it will be positive, so I just put on plus. This is a 2x plus x squared and then e to the 2x. Yep. And then all divided by this guy, 1 plus e to the x and then raised to the third power. And let me just double check before I box the answer or anything. Okay. Yes, I got this one right this time. All right. Well, I do have to tell you that I did practice this beforehand earlier, but I just want to provide a better organization for all the steps. So hopefully this is clear, and maybe with this being done, I can reassign these questions to my Calculus 1 students for homework. Let me know what you guys think though. That's it.